One hot night, Benjamins were all having trouble falling asleep. It was like an oven in there. It felt like they were being roasted on the skillet.
I am so hot, said Thomas. I feel like I have COVID-19.
It feels like we're in the Sahara, said Percy.
Hey Gordon, said James. When our drivers come to the sheds, tell them to turn the air conditioner down and turn on our ceiling fan, and tell them we want it on high speed and blowing air.
Okay, said Gordon proudly. I will.
So when their driver and fireman came, Gordon told them all about it. And they went to work to adjust all the settings. After the settings were changed, all the engines felt much better.
It feels like a good old refrigerator, said Henry.
Wow, this is even nicer than the air conditioner at my shed, said Toby. Heck, I am so dang cold that I feel like wearing my winter's coat for crying out loud.
Can we get some sleep now? Said Edward. I'm tired.
I'm tired, agreed James. Splendid red engines like me need good sleep.
And they all fell asleep like a tired family. The next morning it was still very hot and the sun was smiling today as well.
What is the temperature today? Asked James.
It's 105 degrees, said Thomas.
What? Oh my gosh, no way I'm working today, said James.
Okay everyone, I checked the forecast today and we are having a heat wave at 5 o'clock. So all you engines will work until 5 and then all come back to Tidmouth sheds.
Yes, sir, they all said.
And one more thing, when you take on water, we have propellant beds, so that you can keep your salts up. And that should be everything, Sir Tottenhat said.
And he left.
We sure like the sound of propel, said Henry.
Me too, said everyone.
I wonder what flavors there are, asked Percy.
Let's get to work and stop chatting, said James.
Meanwhile, Diesel 10 was working nearby and heard about the steam he's getting watered with propel. He was not happy about it at all.
The steamies are so lucky to get propel in their water to cool them down and keep them hydrated. All I can get is diesel fuel. I'm so overworked in the summertime. It's not fair. The steamies always get more attention than me and the other diesels. It'd be nice for Pinchy to get some water. I'm going to go to talk to the diesels back at the diesel works about this.
So Diesel 10 went off very sad.
Hello everyone.
Diesel 10, why do you look so sad?
I wish I can get water like a steam engine, and then get this propel booster to help keep their salts. But I can't get any of that since I'm a diesel, and all I use is diesel fuel.
I agree, said Diesel. It is so hard to work in the summertime. You get so overworked.
Then Diesel got a naughty idea.
Hey Diesel 10, why don't we get revenge on those engines? Let's ruin what they have.
Diesel 10 listened to that idea, and as usual, he liked it.
Good idea, said Diesel 10. That will teach those steam engines once and for all.
At the diesel works, Diesel 10 and Diesel were making a plan.
All right, Diesel, we are going to set wildfires with Pinchy.
I will use my claw to light the match when we get to Tidmouth Sheds.
Okay, Bounce, said Diesel.
And they went off.
All right, Diesel, we are going to Tidmouth Sheds and throw the match.
For going there, Percy was on the same line as they were both going down the track. Percy saw something suspicious.
Diesel Tang, why do you have matches in your crown?
I am just going to light some candles at the Engine Country Club.
Yeah, but I think you're lying, Diesel 10, just how you lied to me on Day of the Diesels.
Hello, Percy. Diesel said you might come to visit. What an honor. It's been a very long time.
Oh, come on, Percy. Just give me another chance. That was 10 years ago, said Diesel 10.
Okay, Diesel 10, said Percy, but if you're lying, I'm going to be mad!
Percy went off.
Diesel 10 and Diesel are ready with their matches.
Diesel 10's claw was a bucket of fire.
All right, Diesel, we're here.
Sound great, Bounce,
Diesel said.
So Diesel 10 aimed his claw like he was trying to aim a shotgun.
And he threw the match like a baseball pitcher. And it went straight for Tidmouth Sheds.
Bam! The match was doing what it was supposed to do, burn things down.
Diesel 10 and Diesel laughed wickedly.
The Steamies will love what happened to their shed, Diesel 10 said.
And Diesel simply agreed.
Sooner than later, the engines heard the news and called the Sodor Search and Rescue Center engines.
Bell and Flynn had just filled up their water tanks, and they were ready and raring to go.
They went off like two furious old men.
The engines were desperately waiting for Bell and Flynn.
Hurry, said Toby, or else I'll have to go back to my old shed.
Bell and Flynn came into the situation like some new age kids on some rad skateboard.
Ready to take this fire down, Bell?
Yes, I am, Flynn, said Bell.
And the fire was out.
Yay! Said all the engines. Thank you!
Then Sir Tottenham heard all the noise.
Oh my gosh, what happened here?
Asked Sir Topham.
Thomas Finn explained.
Diesel 10 Diesel threw a match at Tim's sheds, and then the sheds got on fire!
I see, said Sir Topham Hatt. Oh, both scoundrels, I'm going to show them a thing or two. All the trouble they caused to my railway, I'm going to have to think of a punishment for those two bad boys about the sheds. I am going to get some security guards sent to the diesel works so that both diesel cannot move or escape.
Good idea, said James.
And I'm going to help build the sheds,
asked Percy,
since we really don't have a building company right now.
I am going to talk to Andrew Moore from the Mainland Railway about it and see if he can make our own building company to help rebuild the sheds.
How is Andrew Moore going to help? Asked Gordon.
Sir Topham Hatt explained, the reason why I'm doing this is because we need special building materials to rebuild the sheds, and those building materials come from the other railway. That is why I'm going to try to make a deal with Andrew Moore to see if he will do that. And I'm going to have Henry take me.
Why don't you take me, sir? I'm a splendid red engine, said James vainly.
Sir Topham Hatt scolded James. James, the reason why I'm not taking you is because you are very vain about your paintwork, and I don't need to hear your mumbo jumbo.
When are you two going to be leaving? Asked James.
We are going to be leaving tomorrow morning at 11 o'clock a.m. I'll see you tomorrow, said Sir Topham Hatt.
And the engines went back to the busted Tidmouth sheds to get a good night's rest.
When Henry woke up the next morning, he was all ready to go. So he checked on Sir Topham Hatt to see if he was ready to go.
Sir Topham Hatt, are you ready to go?
Asked Henry.
Yes, I am, Henry.
And then they went back to the turntable to tell the engines that they are going to be leaving.
All right, engines, we are going to be leaving.
Then he told the engines what jobs they had to do for the day. Then he and Henry went off.
Goodbye, Henry, said all the engines. We will miss you.
Everything was going well for Henry and Sir Topham. It was a nice sunny day, so they didn't have to worry about bad weather. On their way there, they saw Salty, who was coming back from the mainland. Henry stopped and had a chat with him.
Hey, Salty, said Henry. How are you doing?
I'm doing good, said Salty. Just finished my last job on the mainland, and I'm going back to the docks now.
How was your trip to the mainland?
It was great, me hearties. How is your trip coming along?
Going great, said Henry. At least it's not like the time Gordon went when there was a huge thunderstorm.
All right, you two, said Sir Topham Hatt. That's enough chat.
And they went off. Back on Sodor, everything was going well. All the engines were doing their jobs that they were supposed to do. On the mainland, Henry and Sir Topham just got to Big Ben. Andrew Moore was out there waiting for them.
Hi, Andrew Moore. How are you doing this morning?
Good, said Andrew Moore. Who is this engine you got here?
His name is Henry, said Sir Topham. He brought me here just like Gordon did back in the day.
Hello, Andrew Moore,
said Henry.
Hello, Henry, said Andrew Moore.
Way. Oh, I remember you, Henry. I saw you last Christmas back at the North Pole.
What do you want me to do?
Asked Henry.
First, I want to have a meeting with Sir Topham, and then I will tell you what to do. You just wait right here.
Okay,
said Henry, and he did exactly that.
Then Sir Topham and Andrew Moore's meeting started.
So, what did you want to have a meeting about, Sir Topham? Asked Andrew Moore.
Let me explain. My two diesels, Diesel and Diesel 10, blew up my sheds, and I don't know why, but they're going to be punished extremely, severely, and maybe even scrapped as soon as I return to Sodor. And then, my two fire engines, Flynn and Bell, put out the fire, but the shed is ruined. So I was wondering if you could give some of your special building materials. It would be very nice of you. And one last question. What company do you get them from? Asked Sir Topham Hatt.
I have a new building called Moore Materials, said Andrew Moore. They do bricks, wood, timber, tile, granite, stones, etc. They opened up on March 30th, almost 2 months ago.
Wow, I never knew that.
I wish I was there when it opened. And fun fact, that's when episode 9 came out.
Cool, said Andrew Moore. I watched that episode in my spare time. It was a fun and simple episode.
I agree, said Sir Topham. Which episode is your favorite?
My favorite episode was Thanksgiving to Remember.
That's a good one, said Sir Topham.
I liked how I was the head guy, and I liked the whole idea in general.
I agree, said Sir Topham. Hey, Andrew, why don't you go there together just for fun, since we haven't seen each other since episode 6?
That sounds good to me.
Hey, Henry, have you heard of Andrew Moore's new building material place? It's called Moore Materials. It's a place that has a lot of building supplies like bricks, wood, stone, etc.
Well, Andrew Moore, you are quite the man.
Thank you, Henry, said Andrew Moore. And they went off. The sun was shining, and the temperature was 75 degrees. It was a nice day to travel.
Here we are, said Andrew Moore.
Wow, this place was great,
said Henry.
I wish I could go inside, though.
I know what you mean, said Andrew Moore.
Let's go inside, said Sir Topham Hatt.
What building materials do you need?
Let's see, I need bricks, stone, and timber.
All right, said Andrew Moore, let's go to aisle 10.
All right, said Fat Hat.
Okay, Sir Topham. How many intermodals of brick, stone, and timber do you want to get?
I want 2 intermodals of bricks, 2 intermodals of stone, and 2 intermodals of timber.
Okay, said Andrew Moore, and he did just that. He got an employee to help him.
And he came back with 6 intermodals.
Thank you, Andrew, said Sir Topham. Let's get these bad boys in.
So they went to work putting those weight lifts in those intermodals.
All right, all done, my man, said Sir Topham. Let's go to checkout.
Heck yeah, said Andrew Moore. So they went to the checkout line.
Hey Jim, said Andrew Moore, how are you doing at a 10?
10, said Jim. Who do you got over there?
My good friend, Sir Topham.
Hello, Jim. My name is Sir Topham Hatt, and I am the controller of the island of Sodor.
Cool, said Jim. I have heard about your railway before. It sounds really cool.
Thank you for the compliment.
You're welcome, said Jim.
All right, let me do my magic. So he went to work scanning everything.
Okay, all done, my boys. It costs $1,000.
All right, Sir Topham said. let me pull out my wallet and car. There you go. Now let me put my card back in here.
Bye bye, said Jim.
See you.
See you,
said Sir Topham Hatt and Andrew Moore. They left more materials.
Wait a second, said Andrew Moore. We forgot to take pictures to show Henry.
Oh yes, said Sir Topham.
So he got his camera out.
There you go, said Andrew Moore.
Nice pictures, said Sir Topham.
And they finally left the store. Henry waited like an angel until they came back. Then he saw Sir Topham Hatt and Andrew Moore.
Hey guys, said Henry.
How did you like my new place? Asked Henry.
It was great, said Sir Topham. Me and Andrew had a great time.
Here are the photos we took just for you.
Wow, Andrew Moore, you are a great photographer.
Thank you, Henry. I have a question. We need an engine to shunt us some trucks.
Good point, Andrew,
said Sir Topham. Then Donald came along. He was going back to the island of Sodor.
Hey, look who it is! It's Donald!
Said Henry.
Nice, said Sir Topham. Donald, we need your help, shouted Sir Topham.
What do you need? Donald asked.
I need you to shunt some trucks for my boy Henry.
Yes, sir, said Donald respectfully.
So he went to the shunting yard to get some intermodal cars for Henry.
All right, let me get these bad boys and I will be back in a flash. Here you go, Henry.
Thank you, Donald.
Then Sir Topham Hatt went back inside to get one of those front loaders to come help to load up the intermodal. So the crane loaded up the intermodal into their special car. And they went back inside Henry's cab.
Full steam ahead!
Yes, sure,
said Henry.
And with a huff. And with a puff, and a creak, and a clank, Henry pulled the big intermodal train.
Everything was going good until it started to rain. They had to stop at a signal until they saw Oliver, the Great Western engine.
Hey, Oliver,
How the heck are you doing in the rain?
Not good. I want to get back to my nice dry shed.
Same here, Mr. Oliver, said Toad.
Same here, Toad. I want to get out of this rain, too. I am going back to the island of Sodor.
Why do you have all those building materials?
Long story short, Diesel and Diesel 10 got a match and burnt down the sheds. So I had to bring all these building materials back to the island of Sodor to rebuild the sheds. I better let you go now. It was nice talking to you,
said Henry. It was nice talking to you, Henry, said Oliver.
And the green engine went off.
Everything was going well. The rain had finally stopped, but it was very wet. They were getting close to home. Until Henry had to stop for coal.
I can't wait to see my friends again,
said Henry.
Me too, said Sir Topham Hatt. I can't wait to see my engines again.
Once Henry filled up with coal, they went off again. Back at Tidmouth Sheds, the engines were setting up a surprise party for Henry and Sir Topham Hatt, and they were almost done with it.
All right, my boys, we are going to blow our whistles once we see them in sight. Then, we are going to say, "Welcome back, Henry and Sir Topham Hatt," and if you don't do it right, you'll get a freight car whipped into the bunker.
Oh yeah, said Thomas.
Sounds good, said all the engines. So they waited like angels. Then, with the rolling thunder of a big green engine, a mighty whistle came in, rolling in at 45 miles an hour, slowing down to a comfortable rate.
I think I hear him coming, said James. Just like that song, "Hear the Engines Coming."
Nice reference, James, said Thomas. That song was in the Miller era for those of you that don't know.
James, said Percy. They're coming. Get into place.
So the engines got into place as fast as they could.
Okay, you hats. You all ready?
Yes, said all the engines.
And then green and black came rolling in.
Welcome back, Henry and Sir Topham Hatt, said all the engines.
Henry and Sir Topham Hatt were shocked. A big party was thrown for them coming back.
Thank you so much, said Sir Topham.
This was so nice of all of you, said Henry.
And I also have a treat for you, said Sir Topham. Remember this, old friend?
The engines gasped. They almost popped a piston when they saw who it was. It was Andrew Moore. No way, it's Andrew Moore.
Hey, Andrew Moore, how are you doing?
I am doing great. How are all you doing?
10 out of 10, they all said.
How was your trip with Henry and Sir Topham?
It was great, said Andrew Moore. I can't wait to tell you all about it. Let's start from the beginning so that you can get the whole context.
So he told the story to the engine.
Great story, sir, said all the engines.
Cut in their buffers.
Okay, hold up,
said Thomas.
I just realized something. You forgot to punish those rascals, Diesel 10.
You're right, Thomas, said Sir Topham. Have my security guards kept him in place?
Yes, sir, said Thomas. We're still at Diesel Works.
Thank you, Thomas, said Sir Topham. I am going there in my car. Andrew Moore, you chill with my engines until I come back.
So with a roar and a tire spin, he went off like a cheetah.
In about 10 minutes, he got to the Diesel Works. And he got out of his car. And did the Black Bottom stomp to the Diesel Works.
Diesel and Diesel 10, you reek of sin and sulfur. I am super disappointed in you two, burning up my property. You think I take this really as a joke. But I don't. This is probably one of the worst things you have ever done, and I thought it couldn't get worse, but it did get worse. Your life is in the wrong direction. Go on that turntable and turn it back around. You should be truly ashamed of yourselves.
Diesel and Diesel 10 were very ashamed of themselves.
We are very sorry for destroying your property. That was very evil of us, Diesel said.
I appreciate you two saying sorry, but that's not going to cut the mustard. You're still going to have to get extremely punished for your actions. That's something that the official show has lacked. But in this show, I give punishment where it is due. I should scrap you, but I'll give you mercy one last time.
Diesel 10, your punishment will be taking Pinchy away and ripping off your paintwork.
Your paintwork is gone as well, Diesel.
I want you to think about what you did, and you two will both be humiliated.
Get to work, please, because that's all you'll be doing from now on. No more fun. Thank you. Now I gotta get back to work.
And Sir Topham Hatt went into his car
and drove away.
Hey everyone, I just punished Diesel and Diesel 10.
Good,
said All Vengeance.
What was the punishment you gave them, sir?
Asked Thomas.
I had the workmen scrape off their paintwork, and I took away Diesel 10's claw, Pinchy. And now, they'll be doing nothing but hard work from here on out.
Ha ha ha! That was savage! That was savage! Just like me!
Indeed, said Sir Topham.
What about building those sheds? Andrew asked.
Oh yes, I better call the sort of construction co.
Hey, Andrew Moore, said All Vengeance. We really enjoy having you here on Sodor, but how long are you going to stay?
I am going to try to stay until you are finished with the sheds, because I want to see them when they are finished.
So I'm going to call the Mainland Railway Ownership Board about it and ask if it's okay. Good plan.
I wonder where we are going to sleep.
It better be good enough for an engine like me,
said Gordon.
Hey, by the way, Percy, remember when you had that green metallic paint? When did you get rid of it?
It was too hard to keep clean, so I went back to my normal green coat of paint.
How come it took you so long to notice it? Get yourself some glasses.
I don't know, said All Vengeance.
Well, that is rude. Go to the eye doctor.
At that moment, Andrew Moore walked up.
I finished my call with the Mainland Railway Ownership Board, and I can stay until y'all get finished.
Yay! Said all vengeance.
After 10 minutes passed, Soldier Construction came to help rebuild the shed.
Hello, said the Topham Hat. Thank you for coming over. How long will this take?
It will take 7 days, said the workman.
Nice! Let's get to work, said the Topham Hat.
So the workmen started their work.
Sir, said Thomas, I just had a crazy thought. Where are we going to sleep for the next 7 days?
You will sleep at the wooden railway timber sheds until these sheds get finished.
But sir, we are too big for those sheds.
Never fear, Thomas. The portal will make you wooden style.
What portal? Asked Thomas.
Remember the one from episode 6, the one you used to go to the North Pole.
Oh yeah, now I remember, that's a good idea, and a good way to use it. Let me tell that to my boys.
Boys,
said Thomas,
Sir Topham Hat gave me a really good idea. You know the portal that we used to get to the North Pole?
Yes, said all the engines.
Well, we can use that bad boy to make us wooden style, so we can sleep at the wooden timber shed.
Good idea, said all the engines.
Engines, said Sir Topham, I want to have a little meeting here.
Okay, said all the engines.
First off, me and Andrew Moore will be checking everything to make sure everything gets done right. Then, I will go through the portal to tell you what jobs to do. And then, I will go back and chill with Andrew Moore.
Nice, said all the engines.
Let's go through the portal, guys.
So they went through the portal.
This is a nice change of pace, my boys.
Indeed, said all the engines.
Let's go to our sheds first, so that we can get all cozy.
Good idea, said all the engines.
Wow, this feels like home, said Percy.
And it feels like we're at a hotel, too, said James.
So they had a little chit-chat.
Then they explored the new place.
Then nighttime came. And Sir Topham Hat came to the shed.
Hey engines, how the heck are you enjoying this wooden railway?
Fantastic, said all the engines.
How are the sheds coming? Asked Gordon.
Great, said Sir Topham. They're sucking really good so far.
Yay! Said all the engines.
Do you want to see? Asked Sir Topham.
Yes, said all the engines.
So Sir Topham showed them photos of the progress.
Wow, this is coming along good, said Toby.
Indeed,
said Sir Topham.
I wonder if they will do any new upgrades.
Maybe they'll add a wash down from my red coat of paint.
No, they won't do that because you are too vain,
said Thomas.
And you are way too much of a savage, said James.
Look who got roasted, Toby said. I think the next celebrity roast should be you.
No, Toby. I said it was going to be James, and I am sticking to that.
We probably need to get to sleep now, don't you think?
Said Percy.
Yeah, I agree, said all the engines.
When they got up the next morning, it was bright and sunny.
Rage? And shame, my boys.
Then Sir Topham came to the sheds.
Hello, everyone. How the heck are you?
Good, said all the engines.
Sheds are coming along nicely so far. And I will show you once you finish all your jobs. Thomas, I want you to pull Annie and Clarabelle. Percy, I want you to pull some water tankers. James and Gordon, I want you to pull passengers.
Henry? And Edward and Toby,
I want you to pull freight cars.
And they went off like good engines.
Thomas pulled coaches smooth as butter. Percy pulled the water gently like waves in the ocean. James and Gordon pulled passengers like policemen chasing after a car.
Henry, Edward, and Toby worked hard until the sun went down.
And it repeats for another 6 days.
Hey, engines. The sheds are finished. Who wants to see the goodness of the workmen?
Heck yeah, said all the engines.
Whoa, they look so good, sir.
Said all the engines.
Don't thank me, thank the workmen.
Thank you, workmen.
You're so very welcome.
How do you do it so fast?
Asked Percy. Teamwork, the workman said.
Good job, workmen, for fixing my shed back up, said Sir Topham.
Thank you, said the workman.
Sir, what about Andrew Moore? Asked James.
Oh yeah, said Sir Topham Hatt. Hey Andrew, said Sir Topham, don't you have to go back to the mainland now?
Yes I do, sadly, said Andrew.
Now that I think about it, who's going to take you back to the mainland?
Why don't you use Spencer? Gordon suggested.
Good idea, said Sir Topham. I will contact the Duke and ask for permission.
So Sir Topham Hatt gave him a call and told him what he wanted to do.
All right, I just told the Duke and Spencer will come over in 10 minutes.
Let's enjoy our time, said all engines.
I really enjoyed the time I spent with you and your engines.
I am glad to hear that, said Sir Topham.
We will miss you, Andrew Moore, said all the engines.
I bet the mainland will be happy to have you back, said Toby.
I can't wait to go home.
I like your new place, said Henry. There are really nice buildings to play.
Thank you, Henry, said Andrew Moore.
Then Spencer came with his special coach.
Hey, everyone, said Spencer. Who am I transporting today?
Andrew Moore, one of my closest friends.
And ours, too.
He is a high-end businessman. He is the controller of the mainland railway and owns a warehouse called Moore Materials.
Cool, said Spencer. Hello, Andrew Moore. This is Spencer the Grand.
Nice to meet you, Spencer, said Andrew Moore.
Then they had a little chat.
Then Andrew Moore went into Spencer's coach.
And then the engines gave a great big peep. See you, said all the engines. We will miss you.
I will miss you too, said Sir Topham.
Goodbye, said all the engines and Sir Topham.
And Spencer went off into the sunset.
That was so much fun, said all the engines.
Indeed it was, said Sir Topham Hatt. I need to get back to my office. See you soon, my friends.
See you, sir, they all said. And they went back into their berths.
Wow, this was like our best time with Andrew Moore, said Thomas.
We all agreed, said all the engines. Then the engines talked for a little while and enjoyed their sheds. They were very satisfied. The end.